child with a gun in every hand. All along this countryside he opened many a door, but he was never known to hurt an honest man. Talk about with his lady by his side, he took a stand, and soon the situation there was all but straightened out, for he was always known to lend a helping hand. All across the telegraph his name it did resound, but no charge held against him could they prove, and there was no man around who could track or chain him down. He was never known to make a foolish move. In chains, I offered her my hand. She took me by the arm. I knew that very instant she meant to do me harm. Apart from me this moment, I told her with my voice, said she, but I don't wish to, said I, but you have no choice. I beg you, sir, she pleaded from the corners of her mouth. Accept you, and together we'll fly south. Just then Tom Paine himself came running from across the field, shouting at this lovely girl and commanding her to yield. And as she was letting go her grip, up Tom Paine did run.
sorry, sir, he said to me. I'm sorry for what she's done. Alive as you are me, tearing through these quarters in the utmost misery, with a blanket underneath his arm and a coat of solid gold, searching for the very souls whom already have been sold. Arise, he cried so loud with a voice without restraint. Come out, ye gifted kings and queens, and hear my sad complaint. No martyr is among ye now whom ye can call your own. But go on your way accordingly, and know you're not alone. St. Augustine, alive with fiery breath. And I dreamed I was amongst the ones that put him out to death. Oh, I awoke in anger, so alone and terrified. Put my fingers against the glass and bowed my head and prayed.
There must be some way out of here, said the joker to the thief. There's too much confusion, I can't get no relief. Businessmen, they drink my wine, plowmen dig my earth. None of them along the line know what any of it is worth. thief he kindly spoke. There are many here among us who feel that life is but a joke. But you and I, we've been through that, and this is not our fate. So let us not talk falsely now. The hour is getting late. All along the watchtower, princes kept the view, while all the women came and went, barefoot servants too. Outside in the distance, a wildcat did growl. Two riders were approaching, the wind began to howl. Frankie Lee and Judas Priest, they were the best of friends. So when Frankie Lee needed money one day, Judas quickly pulled out a roll of tens and placed them on a footstool just above the plotted plain, saying, "Take your pick, Frankie boy, my loss will be your gain." Well, Frankie Lee, he sat right down and put his fingers to his chin, but with the cold eyes of Judas on him, his head began to spin. "Could you please not stare at me like that?" he said. "It's just my foolish pride. But sometimes a man must be alone, and this is no place to hide." Well, Judas, he just winked and said, "All right, I'll leave you here, but you better hurry up and choose which of those bills you want before they all disappear. I'm gonna start my picking right now, just tell me where you'll be." Judas pointed down the road and said, "Eternity." "Eternity," said Frankie Lee, with a voice as cold as ice. "That's right," said Judas, "eternity, though you might call it paradise." "I don't call it anything," said Frankie Lee with a smile. "All right," said Judas Priest, "I'll see you after a while." Well, Frankie Lee, he sat back down, feeling low and mean, when just then a passing stranger burst upon the scene, saying, "Are you Frankie Lee, the gambler, whose father's deceased? Well, if you are, there's a fella calling you down the road, and they say his name is Priest." "Oh, yes, he is my friend," said Frankie Lee in fright. "I do recall him very well. In fact, he just left my safe." "Yes, that's the one," said the stranger, as quiet as a mouse. "Well, my message is he's down the road, stranded in a house." Well, Frankie Lee, he panicked, he dropped everything and ran, until he came unto the spot where Judas Priest did stand. "What kind of house is this," he said, "where I have come to roam?" "It's not a house," says Judas Priest, "it's not a house, it's a home." Well, Frankie Lee, he trembled, he soon lost all control over everything which he had made while the mission bells did toll. He just stood there staring at that big house as bright as any sun, with 4-and-20 windows and a woman's face in every one. Well, up the stairs ran Frankie Lee with a soulful bounding leap. And foaming at the mouth, he began to make his midnight creep. For 16 nights and days he raved, but on the 17th he burst into the arms of Judas Priest, which is where he died of thirst. No one tried to say a thing when they carried him out in jest, except of course the little neighbor boy who carried him to rest. And he just walked along alone with his guilt so well concealed, and muttered underneath his breath, "Nothing is revealed." Story. The moral of this song is simply that one should never be where one does not belong. So when you see your neighbor carrying something, help him with his load. And don't go mistaking paradise for that home across the road.
The courthouse.